And every time he hurts you, I heard you. Your shoulder to cry on. And every time you find one.
Hello.
Hello, you gorgeous thing. How are you?
I'm great. How you doing?
I'm good. Thank you for doing this. I'm so appreciative. This is, we're doing a big Detroit special, and we couldn't do a Detroit special without you having taken part in the Detroit special, seeing as you're the biggest thing to come out of Detroit in recent years. How are you doing?
I'm good. I just kind of got up, but yeah.
You have a late night in the studio or what?
Yeah.
You're always in the studio. You're just relentless. First of all, congratulations on Kamikaze, which I really love. For me, it's just the grittiest thing you've done for a while. And I just, you know, being a big fan of your gritty stuff, I am very happy. And obviously, the proof of the pudding is that it's doing so bloody well.
Wow, thank you. Yeah, thanks. I appreciate that, Elton, especially, you know, coming from you.
I've known you now since we did the Grammys together, and I remember coming down to the Valley in L.A. to rehearse with you. Obviously, we did Stand together, and when I saw you rehearsing, I got chilled up my spine. I hadn't seen anybody do that kind of thing to me since I saw Mick Jagger in the early days.
Wow.
And not only are you a great studio artist, but you also go out and one of the few rap, hip-hop people that go out and actually do shows. You were the first person, really, to go out there and really conquer the big, big arenas, big stadiums. So you've been doing it since 1999 now. How does that feel?
I'm blessed. You know, I think that we both are, in the sense of being able to have longevity, you know?
Yeah.
Like, it only comes with hard work, you know? And
hard work and passion too.
Yeah.
If you lose your passion, you're dead. You know?
Right.
And you did the Trump video, which was amazing, for the BET Black Entertainment Television Award video when Revival was coming out. And it was so powerful. And you're one of the few people to actually get up and say something, and I really admire you for doing that.
Oh, thank you. That was one of those things I just felt like
It was pretty on the spur of the moment. I know I spoke to you about it because we call each other from time to time and we have a good old chat. But I know it was kind of on the spur of the moment, and you did the video on the spur of the moment. And it was, sometimes those things work out the best. Can you tell me a little about it?
Well, yeah, the original plan was that I was supposed to go to the actual BET Awards.
Right.
And perform it there, like live, right? So that was the original plan. So I had wrote a different kind of thing for that.
Right.
And it kind of got switched at the last minute because the question was brought up about, I guess it's the BET Awards are pre-taped. Right. I don't know if they're pre-taped every time, but this particular time they were pre-taped. And they were worried about people in the audience with their cell phones, and then whatever I say gets out there in the wrong context or just pieces of it, you know. So it kind of got switched the last minute for them to come to Detroit. So I had to switch some things around.
And you ended up in a car park and in a great video. So it all worked out.
We were basically a homage to Public Enemy's cover of You're Gonna Get Yours, which is like a 12-inch single back in the day. But that was kind of what we were trying to play off of, was that.
Well, it really worked, and it's brilliant. The new album is doing so well. You're still as feisty as you ever were, which I love. I do like a little bit of feistiness. And I'm very happy that you've said you're not going to use the word faggot anymore, because I think you're bigger than that. And I'm glad you said that and cleared that up. And it's great. Kudos to you for that. Well done. And, you know, you've had your little moments towards Machine Gun Kelly, and you put out the dish track Kill Shot, which I love, by the way. And that's doing great as well. So you couldn't really be having a bigger moment than you are now. And that all comes after the relatively disappointing reaction to Revival, and which you must have been really pissed off about, right?
It was one of those things that, you know, stepping away from it now, I think I realized, like, Revival might, you know, with Kamikaze, I tend to, a lot of times, what I usually try to do on albums is, and I think that what people probably have gotten accustomed to is me taking some risks.
Right.
And I think that Revival was probably just too tame of an album, or too, you know, tame.
Yeah. So you went in the studio and did another album straight away, and it really worked. And that's great. You have great knowledge of where you stand in the world. And sometimes a non-success can spur you to do bigger things. And I found that as well. So well done to you.
Oh, thank you.
And listen, thank you for doing this. I know how busy you are and how you're all over the place, but you're also all over the studio all the time. It's great for you to talk to us, especially as we're doing the Detroit thing. It's you and Aretha that we're featuring from Detroit. And I love you. I hope I see you, and I hope I see you soon. Congratulations on everything. And love you so much, and speak to you soon, buddy.
All right, Elton, love you too, man. Take care.
Bye.
Good luck with everything right now.
Thanks. Thank you so
much. The store and everything, man.
Thanks.
Okay.
Bye. And every time he hurts you, I...